Hey, it's nice to meet you. How are you?
Hi. Thank you for having us.
It's a total pleasure. Look, the obvious question right here is, when did you first hatch the idea or find out or even consider the idea of a collaboration with Selena on the song Ice Cream? Who sort of brought that to the table in the band, or how did that happen?
Also, we've been aware of her for a very long time.
Big fans.
Yeah, and luckily when this song came out from our song cam,
so we had it for a while.
Yeah, we had the idea to have Selena on it because we obviously knew she would fit into it right away. And yeah, it happened very naturally.
The song Ice Cream is perfect for the summer that could have been, and it's not the summer that we all wanted. It's you know, the world has been, it's been the craziest year, 2020, a lot of growth, a lot of change. And my question for you is, you know, what would you have liked to have done this summer? What was the plan before everything changed?
Definitely. I think we would be on our world tour right now.
We would have been going around meeting up
and and then have our little days off in different countries and maybe do a little tour around the cities, and because we never really have the time to go travel around the world.
Have you been making music and creating, you know, as BLACKPINK in the time that we've been spending, you know, primarily in isolation around the world? Have you been able to use that time to be creative?
Definitely.
Yeah, definitely.
We're working on a full album right now, so and for like a couple of months now, almost like
past 8 months, we've been in the studio,
helping us get more like, you know, focused into completing the album and making it, you know, the best thing we could give to our fans, and you know, perfecting it and everything. And so I feel like we hope that this album could give a lot of light and energy to everybody that's, you know, kind of stuck at home, you know, not knowing what to do. Hopefully this can cheer them up.
Was it, you know, a fun experience? Were there moments when you didn't want it to end? Because I always think when you're in the studio making music and you're in such a creative space, that it kind of gets to a point where I'm not sure I want to stop making music. Like, I just want to carry on and keep going. Like, has it been a little bit like that for you?
Like, the funny thing is, we were talking to our producer the other day, and he was like, we're like on such a roll right now that we feel like even after we're almost at the final stages of completing the album, and we were actually talking about how we should, you know, we should keep this
carry on.
Like, yeah, because we've been in the studio literally every day for the last 2 months. Mm-hmm. Like, so like every single day, you know, even if we have like different schedules, we like finish our schedule and be at the studio. And he said, you know, this doesn't happen every day where we're like literally in, you know, working and producing and recording mode. So he was like, we should actually still get together and try to see if we could create more things.
How many songs do you think? I mean, in order to try to narrow it down to a full-length album, if you've been in the studio every single day creating, I mean, how many songs do you have to choose from?
I don't think every single day creates more songs. I think it just creates more of like, you know, yeah, quality songs. Mm-hmm. Let's say, yeah, sometimes it even means taking out songs that we feel like wouldn't, you know, complete the album. Mm. I don't think it's about like the number of songs. I think that's like been a big thing for us too. We're not always about giving people like a lot of songs, whereas we try to work on like a few songs that, you know, we can complete and give our best performance within. So
that's one of the things I really like about the way that you've moved as a group, is that you haven't, like you say, you haven't just drowned us in music. You haven't just constantly released music after music after music. Every time you've come back, it's been an event and it's been a moment.
We were all trained to work as a group, and until that moment comes, we're not going to do it. Like, if we're going to half as do it, we're not going to do it.
I think
we had that in our mind. Day one, we got together.
I think it's also kind of in our personalities too. Each one of us, we don't really like putting things out when we feel like it's not fully done.
Great points. And, you know, Jenny, just getting back to something you said before about, you know, four people, being in a group is challenging. And people don't know that. When they see the videos and they see the live performances and they see the interviews and all that stuff, they're like, wow, it's just fantastic. But it's hard enough to find someone, one person that you can spend the rest of your life with, let alone, you know, three, four, five people you can spend 10, 20, 30 years with if you're lucky, right, and go on that journey. It requires real chemistry and real friendship. And, you know, I'm interested to know how important that friendship is, because it's one thing to inspire each other and to move well as a band and to know you can make great music. But it's another thing mm-hmm. to support one another. And that must have been something that's been really a really good part of this experience, is to get to know each other as friends, regardless of Blackpink.
We think the friendship between us is a very important aspect for our group, and we try to keep that in a very naturally, like without love, you know. We don't have to try too hard, but it always needs to be there. So we remind each other all the time that, you know, when you're going through a hard time, we have the hard time with you. So, you know, share and let it go, you know. Yeah. Each year, I think we learn so much about each other. Yeah. And so in that way, we get to respect each other more and give the space that they need. And when they need us, like, we could kind of just look into their eyes and then be like,
and you know,
what's wrong?
Yeah.
You know? Right away. Yeah. Yeah. We would know. And,
you're like, don't talk to Lisa right now. Just don't talk to Lisa. Just back off.
Sorry, guys. I think we all have those.
You'll remember the funny moments and the moments, you know.
Embarrassing moments.
Yeah.
When Jisoo was like, I remember when you did that. And that'll be what you remember. That's
crazy with her memories. She reminds us.
But I think that those are the moments that, you know, kind of help us to define separate shows. Because we did so many, like, last tour, we did so many of the same shows. Like, and we almost forgot, like, wait, where did this happen? Like, in which country was that? You know? And so, like, I think those moments make us go, oh my God, remember in, like, Amsterdam this happened?
You know, I think one of the most important things that Blackpink represents is the idea of strong female creativity and a strong, like I said, hard-edged pop presence. And, you know, there's no question about it that you really do relate to, and your female fans relate to you, and you represent and mean a lot to young women and what they you know, what you represent. And I just wanted your thoughts on that, because I think it's really important we continue to inspire, and you are an inspiring group. And I wondered if you have a message on that level.
For us, I think, you know, it's a very overwhelming feeling to hear like from our fans all around the world, you know, saying that we inspire them, we give them, you know, positive vibes. But, you know, despite the message that we give out on our lyrics, I think just our fans covering our dance performances and like dressing up as us and feeling confident, I think, you know, that's the most, you know, just, it's, you know, you don't get that anywhere. Like, you don't see people just trying to dress up like you and try to dance like you and trying to lip sync the lyrics that you're saying, not because of they love the message so much, but just because they love seeing us and they like how we combine as a group. And yeah, and we want to bring something new on the table every day. And to the fans that are out there, you know, we're so, so grateful and thankful, and we are ready to carry on this feeling till forever. So yeah, just very thankful.
영향력 있는 뮤지션으로서
제니가 한 말이랑 되게 맞는 말인 것 같아서 이제 우리를 따라해주고 뭐 그거에 따라서 본인의 자신감을 찾아가는 그 모습들을 보면서 우리도 더 영향을 받고 더 멋있게 책임감도 생기고.
Jisoo feels like, just like Jenny said, having fans look at our confidence and then gain confidence and then go out there, spreading that confidence makes us feel more motivated.
That's our inspiration.
It's a beautiful relationship, isn't it? That's the chemistry, because those days when you're feeling low, your fans come through and lift you up, and then you do the same thing for them. And that's this wonderful circle, you know, that continues to exist. Well, it's been great to finally meet you. Like I said, I've been looking forward to it.
Thank you for having us.
Oh, it's a pleasure. Thanks again, and be safe and stay well, and we'll catch up soon. Take care.
Bye.